Hi, Gleek.io fans. Today, we're going to talk about a system context diagram, also known as a data flow diagram level 0. Go to www.gleek.io in your browser and click Create Diagram. When you start working on a new project, you need to know what external entities will be involved and how they will interact with your system. A system context diagram will help you work out these relationships without getting too involved in the details of how your system works. Let's say that we're designing a new social media platform. We'll keep it simple so that our system context diagram doesn't get too complicated. We'll start by drawing a circle at the center of the empty diagram to represent our product. Looks great. Best not to think about all the programming, UX and UI involved in that single bubble. Next, we add our first external entity, the user. As with our product, we aren't going into too much detail about the user at this point. We want our new platform to be profitable, but we don't think our users will pay us yet, so we'll need advertising. That means we need another external entity. Introducing money into the discussion leads to the next external entity, the bank. We'll probably identify more external sources of inputs and outputs as we go on, but that will be enough for us to start working out the initial flow of data. Because we're keeping it simple, we only want our users to be able to upload a single comment each day about their lives. That gives us the first interaction. But even before that, we need the user to give us some information about themselves, such as username, password, and date of birth. So the user gives us two inputs, account info and daily comment. Our platform will send the user a feed of daily comments from others. That's the most basic output from us to the user. Getting to the other entities, our advertisers will send us ads that will serve to the users mixed in with their feed. In return, we'll send some user data to the advertisers for ad targeting. The advertisers will hopefully send us money, which we'll send to the bank. At this point, you can probably start to identify some missing entities and relationships in the structure and flow of our new social media platform. That tells you that the context diagram is doing its job, warning you of potential problems and guiding you in this first step of creating your system. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please share this video and share your examples of the system context diagram in the comments below. Thank you, and happy diagramming!